All right, welcome to FiddleHed Fiddle Lessons. Are you ready for Harvest Home? It's a fun song I'm gonna show you right now. It's kind of a hornpipe, so it's got, not really sure how to define hornpipes. They're kind of like a swinging sort of song, more walking tempo. I'm gonna play the whole song in a little bit of a quicker clip. I'm gonna play single A, single B, and then we'll jump into learning it. Really fun tune. And let's just do it. Okay, start by doing a D major scale. I always like to start tunes with the relevant scale. A good variation, rhythmic variation, would be swing. So let's do swing doubles. Okay, I'm gonna write that down so I can link to the swing video I have for you. All right, so swing doubles, swing singles would be good too. So I'll put a link to the swing video below, but in a nutshell, I could go two different ways. We put an accent on the up bow. It can be kind of a light accent. It's a long, short, long, short, long, short, long, short. Or it could be really more exaggerated. Alright, so kind of just playing around with that will prepare you for the tune. Also practice just string crossing. Tune is full of string crossing. Okay, so the first part of it goes open D to open A, and then D2 to open A. So these four notes, you should really just, you should pause the video and practice this a ton. I'm already swinging it. If you can, it'd probably be a good idea to not swing it as well. And then swing it. Not swing, not swing. All right, so swing is good for like more kind of like walking tempo. Boom, 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 boom. If things get too fast, it's harder to swing. Alright, so anyway, back to this. So if you haven't already done this, pause, practice this a ton. Walk away, look out the window, close your eyes and practice it. Start it on G. Start it on A. And go back to the key we're in, open D. So when this little bit first happens in the song, we do it twice in a row exactly. All right. Then we're gonna do this, starting third on A. So third, open E first. And then we walk down the D scale, starting third on A. That piece. Once more. So we have That's the first quarter of this song, Harvest Home. I'll do it straight, no swinging. Here it is with swing bow. Again, that's the first quarter. It will also be the third quarter of this tune, the A part we're on. Next thing we're gonna do, starting open E, we're gonna go E to open A. All right, now we're gonna go first on E to open A. And then low two on E to open A. So putting this together, we have and then we once more go one on E to open A. So this whole part. But do you see the bow? All right. So then after that, we're gonna do a triplet run. I'm gonna play the whole thing, then break it down. So let's work on that triplet run. Starting open to one, so we're gonna. And then we're gonna go to A string, three, two, one. So we have. I now will cycle that little chunk. And then to finish the run, we do the exact same fingering, but start it on open A. Isn't that cool? Let's put it all together. So fun. All right, let's do it again. Before that, we had, so this is the tricky part, when we have triplets next to regular eighth notes. We have. Notice that the triplets move faster. This is hard, so a way to put, oh, my cat wants lunch. Come on, buddy. Hold on just a second, we're not done with the video yet, okay? Hold your horses. All right, so a good way to get this idea down of how do you play regular eighth notes next to triplets is to do just, don't even play anything but an open string, just do. So what I'm doing is I'm doing a triplet and then kind of two eighth notes swung. Not swing those next two notes. One of my students named Peter, who's 8 years old, we came up with a little phrase to say to help him learn it, and it was spaghetti monster, spaghetti monster, spaghetti monster. So if you can come up with like a cool five-syllable phrase, it might help you. Spaghetti monster, spaghetti monster, or whatever you want to come up with. Then you can practice that on a scale. Because I find this is really hard to teach. And going back to our tune, we have. So I think if you get this, then the rest is, this is the hardest mental thing in the tune. The string crossing is technically hard, like a lot of this. It's technically hard, but this is mentally hard. So I'm gonna cycle what I just did, the second quarter, a few times. And I encourage you to listen and then keep rewinding and playing along, because if you get this, not only will you get this tune, but you'll get a very difficult kind of thing to do in music in general. So here you go. 3, 4. Bowing note, you can slur on the triplets, like slur, slur three. That might make it easier, might make it harder, but you might want to try it. So what we were just looping on is the second quarter of the tune. The third quarter is the same as the first. The fourth quarter starts like the second, but is different. Starts like that. And then we do something different. It's a little easier. So we start with what you have already, and then we're gonna do this. Low two on E, open E, three on A. And then we add second on A. Regular second, high second. And then we add three on A, one on E, three on A. So, the whole fourth quarter. Right arm. Okay, now we're gonna do the whole A part. All right, you ready? You ready? If any of the quarters is you don't have yet, then just rewind and watch it. I'm gonna slowly do the whole A part to harvest home. 3, 4. So let's move on to the B part, and I just want to let you know, just to encourage you, that the second half of the B part is exactly the same as the second half of the A part. So all we need to get in the B part is two quarters, the first and the second. So we don't have that much more to go, not that much more work. And there's some similarities already in that. So anyway, we're going to start, but there's something hard. So we're gonna start with So let's break that down. First go. So those are two eighth notes, two short, short. Then we're gonna add a triplet eighth note. Okay, so three times on this. So we're gonna go. Here's that again. So we're doing eighth note, then a set of three then a set of triplets. So here it is again. I'm just gonna cycle that. If we can cycle that, you don't even need to finger place your hand here so you can really focus on the rhythm, and we're gonna cycle that. By the way, I am swinging the first two eighth notes. Long, short, 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 short. All right, so. If you get that, the beat, rest of the B part's pretty easy. So, because the next thing we do is we do the same thing, but with first on the E. All right, so if you have the rhythm, that's probably not a big step or a hard thing to do. So far in the tune we have. Now we do the same thing with low two on E. And then back to first on E. So we're gonna go. Try all that again, a little slower. So that's the first quarter of the B part. And you know what? It's even easier than I thought because, well, not easier, but there's less to do because the second quarter of the B part is the same as the second of the A. In fact, we just now take the rest of the A part, second, third, and fourth quarter, we copy and paste right here, and we're done with the B part. How about that? So, the second quarter of the B part is. Same as the second quarter of the A part, as well as the third and the fourth. I am now just going to play the entire B part slowly, and if it doesn't make sense, just listen a few times. Listening is also practice. And then you can rewind and play it along with me, okay? So here we go, I'll count you in. 3, 4. And that's it. All right. Well, that was sure fun. I'm glad you made it to another Fiddlehead fiddle lesson. And I'll see you next time, okay? Don't worry. It's not the end. There'll be more. There'll be more. Okay. See you later. My cat, he's bugging me. He wants to be fed. Right, kitty? Okay. See ya.
Thanks for watching the video.
Excellent.